double Daniel along with Brandon Garrett up front. Your officials for tonight's game, Tim Gaddis, Jeff Smith, Steve Devine, a veteran crew, and we are just about set to tip it off. Murray State in the same color tones as the rest of their crowd here, expected to be a sellout in the CFSB Arena. They're wearing their home whites, and they'll be going right to left on your TV screen. Belmont Bruins in their navy blue roadies. Opening tip goes to Belmont, and we are underway in OVC play.
State, they're going to have to guard without fouling because this is a new offense for Rick Byrd, keeping the floor spread.
And the first foul of the game, and a rare opportunity for Belmont getting the ball inside. They're much more an outside shooting team.
Yeah, and Coach said that. He said, well, I've had to make the adjustments. You're going to see a lot of high ball screen and rolls, handoffs. But again, if you're not playing tough defense man-to-man, you'll get exposed by both teams because they can break you down off the dribble.
Dexter Fields, the UAB transfer, gets his first foul, and Blake Jenkins, who sat out Belmont's last game with a wrist contusion, is at the line shooting too. He misses the first one. He's a 68% free throw shooter. As a team, Belmont is fourth in the conference in free throw shooting at 72%.
Well, you can see the body language right now. You can see the guys moving around. You can see the nervous tension right now. So you don't want your key guys to pick up fouls while the adrenaline's still high. Usually you settle down near that first timeout around the 16-minute mark.
Jenkins' second free throw drops and opens the scoring. It's 1-0 Bruins.
This is the first time they faced each other. So in conference play, this is new. Each other figuring out the game speed, the style, and the coaching. This is new territory for both teams.
Number one, Stacey Wilson inside to Daniel. Had it blocked cleanly. That was Trevor Nowak picking up the block.
We're not going to leave Clark. Coach Chrome said, we're not going to face guard him, but we're not going to help a lot off of him.
First touch of the game for Clark. Inside again, and Blake Jenkins has his third point of the night. It's a 3-0 Bruins lead.
But a good thing about Belmont, we talk about them being so hard to guard, you can't double them because the floor is so spread. They give you good, strong passes, and they cut the open areas to try to get yourself a shot.
Both teams trying to work it inside to their respective number twos. That goes off the hands of Ed Daniel. It'll stay Murray State ball. There's Rick Byrd, his 27th season with the Bruins, seventh all-time in wins for active coaches, and tonight marks his 1,000th career game on the sidelines.
Classy guy, classy guy. Steve Prohm said, I'd love to be like him, the staying power, the stamina for him to do what he does at Division I level.
Wilson, deep three off the mark. And we got our first foul on the game for the Belmont Bruins. It's going to go on Trevor Nowak, number 30.
Trevor's going to have to use his fouls judiciously. He can't throw them away because they're going to need his presence. They're undermanned in the post, and that's why Murray State has been trying to get the ball in on the first two possessions in the post.
There's Cannon. Inside BG, Brandon Garrett, the follow slam, no good. Daniel gets another offensive board. Here's Wilson. That was Brandon Garrett with the follow slam. It's 3-2.
You can see the pattern that they want to get it inside. Now this crowd is alive.
There's Mann for three. Knocks it down. I was watching this team warm up, Adrian. They hung more nets and warm-up shots than any team I've seen this year.
That's true. They shoot a soft shot, especially from the three-point line. But both teams want to get that. Murray State wants to get right there in the post. Try to get a point-blank shot. And Belmont bombs away from the three-point line.
Garrett double-team goes out of bounds. Tim Gaddis says it's still Racers basketball. In his second season, as successful at the start of his career as any head coach in the profession, Steve Prohm started last year 23-0 and won a third straight OVC title, has his Racers poised for another strong run at number four this year. Cannon's first shot of the game. the All-American they call Sip for his Mississippi roots as his first three.
Well, they're expecting him to explode. They said he hadn't gone off for 30, 35, or 40, but they're waiting for a big game from him.
Look at Caron Johnson, the number three on the other side. He has his first two, and it's an 8-5 Belmont lead.
Belmont's doing a good thing. Every time Murray State scores, they come down and get a basket, and that's how you can keep the lead and keep the crowd from being as loud as it is.
This is a matchup to watch. Two number threes going toe-to-toe at the guard spot.
But that's good that Johnson's not fouling him, because Isaiah can get his shot off the dribble, but you don't want to foul a dribbler or a jump shooter.
Seven to shoot for the Racers. Wilson with two on the shot clock.
Tough shot. Two bad shots right now. Get yourself inside. Get your feet set by the three-point line.
Rick Bird's got to be happy with the one and done so far for Belmont.
Now look at Belmont's offense. There's nobody in the post. They get most of their offense off the dribble, hard cuts, or the three-point shot.
Inside Baker, surrounded by white jerseys, out of bounds. It'll stay Belmont basketball.
We're talking about two teams that have won a lot of basketball. Belmont's trio have won three championships and 95 career games. And then Ed Daniel and Isaiah Cannon, the seniors, have won 101 games. But we're talking about two teams with veterans that know how to win and finish games.
There's a three that was too hard. Here come the Racers. Fields, spots, fires. Off the back rim. And we've got a foul inside. It'll be on Belmont. A raucous crowd on hand for the OVC's finest. Belmont out to an early three-point lead.
Standards right here, they're undefeated in conference play. Murray State in the Western Division, 7-2. But when you're talking about the Bruins, they shoot 49% from the field, which is eighth in the nation. And then they have a high assist turnover ratio, 19th in the nation, 16 assists per game.
This is the first year the OVC's gone to split divisions, possibly making the case even more so for being a two-bid league this year, which we happen to think they should be.
Well, you're looking at two of the teams right now that have been dynamite, and you got to continue to win games.
Wilson short on the jumper. He's 0 for the field, but he changes that with the follow.
Got himself close to the basket, but that's the challenge for Belmont. They've only won the rebound battle one out of their last eight games. That's going to be key for them. They give up a lot of offensive rebounds, second shots.
Number 22, Reese Chamberlain in blue. In for Belmont, Ed Daniel with the steal. Here's Cannon.
We mentioned these teams going at each other for the first time.
Look out.
Isaiah sensing the moment, but you can scout all you want, but it's hard to recognize somebody at game speed. They're making an adjustment on how quick Isaiah really is in his home building.
There's Clark, hasn't attempted a field goal yet. Chamberlain, short on the three. Belmont comes away with the loose ball and a fresh 35.
Ball movement, nobody forcing shots.
There's a turnover, and Wilson lays it in.
Murray State matching the intensity, one of the crowd, and also of Belmont.
Three from the corner, short. Fields wants the run. Garrett, easy left-hand lay. A 9-0 Racers run, and the largest lead of the early going, 6 points.
Because Belmont doesn't get a lot of second shots, and it's long rebounds, the Racers are just like their name right now. They got their track shoes on racing.
Nice take to the hole from J.J. Mann. He has 5 points.
Good change of pace. They thought he was going to guard the three-point shot and then had the crossover getting to the basket. Both teams are getting what they want offensively. It's the broken plays. And for Murray State, when it's been going off the glass, they have the rebound advantage.
Belmont plays almost exclusively man-to-man. This could be a mismatch for Isaiah Cannon.
We're getting two veteran teams right here. Look at Isaiah taking his time. He's not letting the defense speed him up.
He sensed it. And how about that? Step in offensive foul. And good defensive stance by the reserve Rhys Chamberlain.
Got no problem with that call. Could have gone either way. I got no problem with that call. Rhys picked up a good possession on that one. Moving his feet. I like the intensity though. Isaiah doesn't like the call. He's fired up. Let's see if he can give a positive play on the defensive end.
What did Steve Prohm tell us earlier today? He said he's never seen Isaiah Cannon as dialed in as he is leading up to this game. He feels like this is his lead, and he needs to prove that today.
Well, he said, quite frankly, he thought at times his team has been bored.
Cannon.
That was a statement shot for him, like, this is my gym, this is my town, this is my conference.
First miss of the night.
Defense by Murray State. You have to go second, third option, movement side to side.
Ball's up for grabs. There's a 50-50 ball, and the Racers come away with it. Cannon steps through, and there's a foul before the shot.
Steve Prohm was saying that he thought his guys were bored during some parts of the season, and he said they need this. This is a statement game, a wake-up call, because they haven't seen Isaiah go off like last year. Now, Fields wasn't scoring, and Wilson has been struggling from the outside as well, taking pressure off of him. But just like you said with Sip, they call him from Mississippi, as Sip has been dialed in now, they're expecting a big game from him.
And Isaiah Cannon will take a seat on the bench, get a quick breather. He plays monster minutes every game for Steve Prohm.
And so far, Ed Daniel has not gotten fouled either.
Wilson looking for contact. The follow, no good. That's the freshman C.J. Ford missing the bucket. And Ford comes away with a loose ball on the other end. Wilson, three. Hasn't found his range yet.
The Racers are beating the Bruins to all the second shots right now. Belmont is down one in rebounds, and you can see the long rebounds. You got to be quick to the ball. Block out your man and go pursue the basketball.
Here's Jeffrey Moss for three.
Rhythm shot off a driving kick. Coaches love to see the ball moving and getting points through assists.
And they're going to get a foul on number four in white, Latrez Mouchat. We're under 12 minutes with 11:08 to go. Murray State with a lead at home.
Well, coaches know their teams. Coming into this game, the Bruins had 63 less offensive rebounds. So that's where they've been losing a lot of the battle, second chance opportunities for their opponents.
Ed Daniel on the bench, as is Isaiah Cannon. Let's see where the scoring comes from for the Racers.
I like Belmont's offense. It's spread, and if you can get a hard dribble drive, that frees up right there for the jump shot.
Wide open inside the three-point line. No good. Moss with the rebound. Here comes Wilson. C.J. Ford with the left hand.
This right now is a statement that Murray State is making on their home turf. And for Belmont, they've got to make shots to keep themselves attached to this game and not give any more momentum to Murray State, because right now everything's been clicking for them.
14-2 Racers run, make it 14-4 with that lay-in by Karan Johnson.
Veteran, he and Ian Clark scored over 2,000 points coming into this season, one of only eight pairs to score collectively 2,000 points. So these guys know how to play. both offenses, when they're clicking, are hard to guard because you've got to keep penetration in front of you.
Five on the shot clock. Moss is going to have to force it up. Instead, it's Mushak. He's short, but a fresh 35 for Wilson and company. Nice spin. Off the window. Stacey Wilson has six in the first 10 and a half minutes.
That was beautiful. The crossover and the spin move, but that was off an offensive rebound.
Racers fans wanted to travel. Instead, it's going to be a Murray State foul.
The long rebound right here breaks your back defensively. Then the crossover right here, the quick move, the spin and the finish. For Belmont, they're going to have to give themselves an opportunity and shore up those long rebounds. Typically, the school of thinking, long shots means long rebounds.
And a chance to run. Jenkins hits the first free throw. He has four. And now Daniel and Cannon check back in.
Now, one thing about Belmont, because they're an outstanding shooting team, though they're down by eight, that's only three possessions shooting the basketball. So that's not a big lead for a deficit for a three-point shooting team. That's their knockout punch.
They shoot it at a 46% clip behind the line in OVC play. The miss, the offensive rebound, but a traveling call on number three, Karan Johnson.
Just for Johnson to get in there, smallest guy on the court. Excellent vertical.
And what a story leading into this game. Karan Johnson was recruited heavily by the Murray State staff. He signs with Belmont, which ultimately led to Isaiah Cannon getting signed here at Murray State.
Well, it's win-win, both of them. Karan's got over 95 career wins and some conference championships. Isaiah Cannon's been on the Naismith watch and All-American, so it's win-win for both programs.
Only one turnover for the Racers. That's a major contributor in their current 8-point edge. Five on the shot clock. Cannon. Daniel, top of the key.
You can hit that.
Whoa. Not that time.
Ed, make me look good, son. That was a brick. Goodness.
Here's number 21, Clark. His first shot of the game is good. So already he's shooting a perfect one for one.
Well, not forcing his offense. And again, they're down by six, but they can score quickly. And we're talking about veterans for Belmont.
18th in the country in field goal percentage. Here's a steal. Easy lay-in for Craig Bradshaw. It's down to a 4-point Murray State lead with coming up on 8 minutes to go in the first half.
Belmont has withstood the emotional charge of Murray State. They're settling down, but they're making Murray State have to beat them with good passes and execution.
Garrett left-hand. Brandon Garrett has been an offensive spark in the first half for Steve Krohn's club. 6 points.
Well, right now, when the shot goes up, it hadn't been a fair fight on the rebounds or getting it deep in the post.
Miss for Jenkins, and his fellow number two, Ed Daniel, comes away with the rebound. Cannon got the hand check foul on Clark. The top two scorers in the OVC.
Isaiah froze him with his feet, stopping the hesitation dribble. The lefty going up strong, deep in the post.
Adrian, how about North Carolina head coach Sylvia Hatchell going for win number 900 in her career?
Absolutely. Congratulations to her. That tells you you've been consistent. Had fabulous coaching staff and good players.
So Belmont's down six, but Ian Clark's only had one shot in the game. Advantage who so far?
Well, right now it's Murray State, but it's the shot attempts. You've got nine more shot attempts because they've been pounding the offensive glass. They got nine more rebounds.
Here's Daniel. That was easy pickings for Ed Daniel.
Too easy. Push him out, crowd his spot. You got to be physical with him.
J.J. Mann, top of the key for three.
Oh, I got it.
Off the mark. Big rebound by Daniel. He is a double-double with high tops and an afro.
Leave the J5 alone. It used to be the J5, the Jackson 5 back in the day. But he's a man down low. Doesn't deviate from what he does.
Seventh in the nation in rebounding, seventh in the nation in double-doubles. And he's going to be going to the line and shooting the pair.
That was a great move by Ed. We hadn't seen that move. He faked like he was going to give the handoff back, and then he had a burst right here. That was a good move. Beat him to the spot.
Brandon Baker picks up the foul.
We're both fascinated with the coaches, and they know their teams. Steve Prohm said, this is a game I think can jumpstart the rest of our season because they're looking for a challenge. They're going to play with a chip on their shoulder against Belmont. And then Rick Bird, that's talking about him changing his offense this year. He said, I've always had four players out and one down low that could score. He said, this year I don't have any post presence, so I've got to keep the floor spaced. And he knows that he lives and dies by a lack of post presence in the paint.
And here's another win for Steve Prohm and his Murray State Racers. They've struggled with early foul trouble for number two, Ed Daniel. Right now, 6:40 to go in the first half. He has zero fouls.
Wait, he's focused. He's dialed in, and at times he's casual and indifferent. But I think it's because he's so intelligent that he overanalyzes himself and leads him to be not as productive.
And what you just saw was an easy opportunity for Daniel to pick up the foul, and he did not.
Active hands by the Racers. So look at the calm and the patience by Belmont.
Clark for three. In and out, no good. So he's 0 for 1 from three-point distance, the leading three-point shooter in the nation.
I think Belmont's making the adjustment to the speed and the quickness of Murray State. I think even in the second half, they'll settle down even more. But right now, they've been stunned by the quickness and explosiveness, and they've got to get those rebounds off the glass when the missed shot goes up.
10 on the shot clock. Ball's in Cannon's hands, the All-American. NBA, top of the key, way off the mark.
See Ian Clark smiling, got away with a foul as he took the shot.
And there's the first foul of the evening on Ed Daniel.
He's still got young guys out here, 18 to 23-year-olds. Isaiah took the shot, got fouled, and Ian was going down the court smiling because he knew he got away with one.
Ron Johnson with 4 points on the night, shooting two, a 6'1" senior out of Huntsville, Alabama. Coming into the night with gaudy numbers, 13.7 points a game, 4.7 assists, and 3.6 steals.
Impressive, where his coach said the most competitive player he's ever coached, and he's the MVP over DeMarcus Cousins and Eric Bledsoe coming out of high school. So this young man is a competitive little joker. You can tell by the career wins, too. They've been winning, so this guy knows what he's doing.
Had a career-high 25 earlier this season against Morehead State.
Let's see if Isaiah tries to go back at the defense. He missed it badly, but the scoring instinct in him is to try to get that offense back.
Here's Daniel, double-team.
Patience by Murray State.
Wilson with 8 on the shot clock. The 3-ball from Stacy Wilson, and he has a game-high 9 points and the largest lead of the game for the Racers, 11. Nowak off the mark. And Mushat a rebound.
You're seeing Belmont still in the man-to-man. But they hadn't been fouling in the post, so the missed shot. You got a double team. That's a good double team. And try to recover back out to the shooters.
Wilson back-to-back threes. Clark silences the crowd, if only temporarily, with his first three of the game.
Quick trigger and a quick release. He's a quick, accurate shooter. Belmont's holding on. That was a huge basket for him to try to stop the momentum, because right now Murray State is dialed in on the offensive end.
Racers, Comm Cannons.
Good matchup right here. And for both star players, they haven't fouled each other.
And this time, they'll get Ian Clark with the foul. Maybe a little bit of a makeup call?
No, that was a good play. Isaiah's quick and explosive, a low dribble. You got the scouts over here watching everything he's doing. He's waiting for Clark to make a move on him. Once he engages him right here, watch the blow-by move, and then they're looking for the open shooter. Welcome to the party, Stacy Wilson.
So Ed Daniel doing a little bit of everything and only picking up one foul in the first half. That's great news for Racers fans. Wilson got caught up in the air.
Well, that was a good job by Belmont switching on a double team where Isaiah likes to come off that screen.
Wilson short on the three this time. Nowak tried to corral it, went off his hands out of bounds. It's Murray State basketball.
This is where Juwan Long last year was bombing a lot of shots. These same shots that Stacy Wilson is getting a chance to shoot. Now, if he can hit shots, consistently hit shots, that takes pressure off of Isaiah, and he'll see more one-on-one coverage.
3 minutes to go in the first half. Quick fire, Cannon off the mark.
Belmont's done a good job defensively. Right now, Murray State's just been on fire. They've challenged the shots, and also the rebounds have not been their best friend, but they've been playing a solid floor game.
There's a mismatch up front. Caron Johnson guarded by number 13, Brandon Garrett.
Don't want to foul.
Good hands by Wilson out of bounds. It stays Belmont basketball.
You know what you get with seniors on both sides? When they're playing, when they're focused, they don't beat themselves. Play with poise. Both programs have won big. That's why we talk about this being a super middleweight bout. We talked about Indiana and Michigan was number one and three earlier playing with heavyweights. These are super middleweights going at it.
Ball's out of bounds. It stays with the visiting Bruins. Belmont, no stranger to hostile environments and tough teams. They have the fourth-ranked strength of schedule in the non-conference this season, and they have a number 18 RPI ranking.
Well, they are what they are. They're a group that shares the basketball, high assist, lights-out shooting, and good ball movement.
Heads-up play and a good follow by number two, Blake Jenkins.
Yeah, they're still attached to this game. They're down by nine, but again, this is a three-point shooting team. If you weren't able to shoot from the three-point line, this game would be building and going away from them. But they make shots, and they don't beat themselves. You got to beat Belmont. They won't beat themselves.
2 minutes to go. Fields for three. Yes. Another assist for Ed Daniel, his third. 6 three-pointers on the night for the Racers.
Good feel for the game. One of the greatest things you can have is a high basketball IQ. He's got an outstanding feel for the game. Belmont has good patience against a good defensive team.
Blocked by Daniel. And blocked by Garrett. Man, silences the crowd with a three. This is what we expected.
Well, you're seeing the strength of both teams. The shot blocking by Garrett. Get it out of here. Ed Daniel, get it out of here. But then they quiet you with a three-point shot. This is the strength of both teams. Three-point shooting and inside presence for Murray State.
Wilson rises up, short. Daniel went for the save. And it's going to be Belmont basketball. Ed Daniel has been a stat sheet stuffer this night.
Plays within himself. Doesn't force his action, and a lot of times he'll get cheap, silly fouls. He hasn't had that. He's got to play over his minutes. 30 minutes a game, he's got to get his minutes tonight.
Loose ball out of bounds.
this is a good game because every time Murray State looks like they're going to break it open, Belmont comes back with a timely three-point shot. And I just mentioned they are what they are. They don't have the inside presence of Murray State, but they do share the basketball and they find open shooters.
About a 9.5 second differential between shot clock and game clock. What do you do if you're Steve Prohm on offense? Right?
Well, it's that high screen and roll. If Isaiah gives it up, he usually comes off a screen.
Fields, nice pass inside. Garrett gets fouled. We'll go to the line. ACC Sunday Night Basketball is on ESPNU as Player of the Year candidate Mason Plumlee leads the Blue Devils against Ryan Anderson and the Eagles. Coverage begins with ACC Sunday Night Basketball at 5:30. And it's number 4 Duke and Boston College at 6 on ESPNU and also live on Watch ESPN.
That last play was a well-run play by Murray State. Four guys touched it, the ball changed sides, and then you end up with a free throw. Now you got to pay off that free throw possession, but that was outstanding ball movement by the offense.
Free throw good by Garrett. And the shot clock is off, 25 seconds to go. And we talked about Ed Daniel having an overall great night. 5 rebounds, 3 assists, a block, 2 steals, and oh yeah, he has 3 points as well.
No, and oh yeah, the fro is still working. Fear the fro. It's the Dr. J fro bouncing in the wind. Keep an eye on Ian Clark. He comes off the screen, he'll nail it.
10 seconds to go.
He and JJ Mann, you've got 2 scores out there.
Johnson, 2 to shoot. Gets the shot off, it rims out, and Murray State goes into the locker room with a 10-point halftime lead over Belmont, 36-26. Now let's send it to Matt Schick and Bruins in scoring with 8 points. And while the team is down 10 points, maybe a positive that Rick Bird's club can take away is that Ian Clark has not only scored just 5 points, but he hasn't taken very many shots.
Yeah, Clark and also Trevor Novak has not gotten going yet as well. So we watched him in warm-ups. They shot three-pointers. Murray State warmed up with layups.
That tells you something about Rick Bird's Bruins club, doesn't it?
The strength of that team.
Murray and their home whites going left to right to start the second half. They only turned it over twice in the first half, and already they have their 3rd turnover to start the second half.
Well, that's the first time we've seen Belmont in the zone. I like that they changed up the defense to try to give Murray State's offense a different rhythm and tempo. Keys for Murray State coming out this half is intensity. You got to be intense and also team defense. Guard that 3-point line and attack the rim. That's what Steve Prohm has told us for the second half.
There's Clark trying to initiate contact, but it was blocked by Wilson.
Well, if you can get close to him, he shoots from a low trajectory. He shoots a quick shot, and it's a good release, but it's a low. It's not a high release point. Belmont has not pressured him, so they can take their time and try to pick him apart.
Inside, here's Garrett. He's a natural left-hander, and he uses that left hand off the window.
Well, deep post position has been the advantage for Murray State. Nowak is not able to block his shot or contest the jumper.
Extra pass. Here's Nowak in the corner. No good. Good hustle by Cannon. And Isaiah Cannon's going to go to the line and shoot 2. Cannon had 6 points in the first half, courtesy of 2 3-pointers. So give him 31 consecutive games now with a shot behind the arc.
Well, he had 6 points, but he was looking for his offense, but not forcing it. And that's what you want from a high-volume scorer. He's always looking to attack, but he's being patient, sharing the basketball with teammates.
He now has 7, and with each point, he inches closer to that magical 2,000-point career mark. He came in needing 185 points. So if all goes well for Murray State at the end of the regular season and into the postseason, he could very well reach that mark.
Well, a couple things you like about him for this level and the next level. At this level, he's not turned out by his celebrity. So he's been a marked man for the last 2 years. It's consistent. And at the next level, I don't think $2 or $3 million will change him as well.
14 points, biggest lead of the game for the Racers. Clark, great move.
Moves well without the basketball, can get separation in space. You can't let him get going, but he's a beautiful player to watch offensively when he has space.
Wilson off the curl, short. Mann comes away with it. They have numbers, 3-on-1. And J.J. Mann now has 10 points. They call him a Belmont superfan. He not only helps lead this basketball team, but
watch,
he goes to virtually
programs.
Every other program sporting event.
Getting his money's worth in college. 10-point game right here. For as well as Murray State has played, Belmont is still connected to this game.
Inside Garrett.
Oh!
A nice defensive effort by J.J. Mann.
I remember saying at the 5-minute mark that Belmont were going to the halftime and make the adjustments because of recognizing the first half how quick Murray State has been. And they've adjusted better. They're not getting beat as quick off the dribble.
There are threes going toe-to-toe. Johnson and Cannon. Cannon weaves his way.
Oh!
Comes up empty.
Good move.
Johnson, the blow by, and the nice lead for number two, Blake Jenkins. Jenkins has 8, and the lead is down to 8.
Well, Belmont's undefeated in conference play, and like you said, they've played against the VCUs and the Kansas, so they're not a cupcake team. You're seeing this home crowd saying, listen, we don't like how it's going. Let's get some separation from these guys. Belmont has held Murray State to 1-and-done for the missed shots going up.
Short on the three from Fields. He gets his own miss. Garrett. Brandon Garrett in double digits with 11. He came in averaging only 6.
Well, Brandon had a good warm-up today. He said, no, we're going to come out. He was very relaxed. He said, this is our place. We're not going to let them come and take anything from us.
There's Jenkins, back-to-back baskets for Blake Jenkins, and he's in double digits with 10.
Two teams that are moving the basketball, making themselves hard to guard. Because they space the floor so well and because they make the extra pass, if you get tired, you're going to get beat.
Fields, three ball, corner pocket. Jenkins lost the handle. We've got a foul on the floor, and it's going to go on Murray State. 15:26 to go here. Murray State up by 11. We're going to take a studio update when we come back. Could they possibly be popping to the big dance?
Well, it's spinning. It's spinning right now. But again, for Illinois, that usually lives by the three-point line and dies by it. They live by it on this one. But how about Indiana, the emotional toll as well? A huge win. Coming up earlier in the week and then coming and taking one on the chin by Illinois.
A lot of basketball yet to be played in conference. The same can be said in the OVC. There's Reese Chamberlain with his first two of the game and a chance to make it three the hard way.
Reese Chamberlain has had 3 possessions on Isaiah Cannon, and he's won them both. He drew a charge off of him when he played the few minutes and then coming right in the game and attacking him again. So for what he's matched up with them, he's won 2 out of those 3 possessions.
Chamberlain, a 65% free throw shooter, knocks that one down. His first 3 points of the game, and it's an 8-point advantage for Murray State. And the Racers a little out of control. They give up the ball. That's turnover number 6 now for Murray State.
Murray State going with a smaller lineup now. They're going to have to guard the 3-point line, but the Bruins are getting more comfortable now with how Murray State is playing them. If they can be patient and they move that ball around with excellent cutting and precise passing, they can get what they want on the offensive end.
So Mann inbounds. Chamberlain runs the point. take by Chamberlain. Into the corner for Mann. Short on the three. Belmont an offensive rebound. But they come up empty. The rebound by Fields.
Well, that was a good possession by Belmont. They've done everything but score. They were moving the ball side to side. They got a good look, and they got an offensive putback. See if Isaiah look for his offense in this matchup.
Off the Daniel screen, he lost control.
Still time on the shot clock. Good patience from Murray State.
Five to shoot. Cannon into the lane. Fields, corner. Three is good. Dexter Fields has 9 points on three three-pointers. And Murray State's lead is back up to double digits with 14-12 to go in the game.
Belmont playing with more snap now. Watch the ball movement on offense, playing with more confidence. Both teams run a similar offense. They back it out, they probe the defense, and try to pick you apart on dribble penetration.
There's the turnover. 2-on-2. And they're going to get a foul on number 21, Ian Clark.
You're watching two well-coached teams. Murray State has had a better execution right now. In the last two possessions, Belmont has gotten what they wanted, but then they had a turnover or a missed shot on the easy going. But Murray State has not allowed themselves to be guarded in key possessions so far in this game.
And somewhat surprisingly, neither team's superstar has really lit it up. Isaiah Cannon fouled behind the three-point line, so he's going to be shooting three free throws. Cannon has 8. Ian Clark held in check with just 7, but the reserves on Murray State have really stepped up so far. ESPN's Journey to the Tourney, a season-long spotlight on games that will impact the tournament. On Monday, it's the Sunflower Showdown. Number 13, Kansas State, and number 5, Kansas, all part of Big Monday at 9 on ESPN and also live on Watch ESPN. We watch Indiana go down tonight, but Kansas losing to TCU. There's something about trying to win game number 20 on the year. Kansas had 19 wins. They lost the night before. Wichita State had 19 wins.
Wait,
they lost.
What do you sound like, a baseball pitcher?
Hey,
you got to get 20
all
wins.
All I'm saying is that Belmont came in, and their record, 19-4. Right now, they're trailing it by 12.
Well, you look at right now, Isaiah is at the line for 3 shots. He's generated the last 2 possessions. He generated a nice assist from Fields in the corner off of the pass. And then for himself, speed kills on the basketball court. Because he's so quick and explosive, he was able to draw 3 free throws.
Jeffrey Moss checks in for Stacy Wilson. And the Murray State crowd smelling blood.
Belmont has been able to answer every time. Murray State looks like it's ready to break it open.
This man, he's had a good game. That time they get him for an offensive foul. And the X Factor, Ed Daniels, stepping up.
Add that to his stats now. A block, assist, and a charge right there, taking one for the team. That's an excellent call. J.J. Mann has been able to get mileage out of that deep corner because of his ability to shoot the three-point shot. But the ball faking the separation, he's got to pull up and kiss it off the glass.
And that's 3 fouls on Mann, so number 14 in blue has to sit down on Rick Bird's bench. In comes number 23, Craig Bradshaw, to spell him.
Coach Bird said that J.J. Mann has to be an X factor in Trevor Nowak. When they score baskets, he knows what he's going to get from his stellar backcourt in Johnson and Clark.
And yet Nowak tonight, 0 from the field.
Fields moving with better quickness, especially looking for a shot.
Moss off the mark, Johnson clears. Clark alone for 3. Off the mark.
Phil's got away with one sightseeing because you never leave an open shooter like that. So he got away with one. It's a good matchup up here with Johnson and Isaiah Cannon.
Moss almost lost at 10 on the shot clock.
Similar offenses. You're watching these guys try to beat you on dribble penetration.
The lob, count that as an assist from Isaiah Cannon to Latrez Mouchette. Mouchette's got his first two, and it's up to a 15-point.
Well, absolutely, celebrating good college basketball.
Here in Murray, Kentucky, we've seen some good basketball by the Racers. They're up 15, their largest lead of the game, on undefeated in conference play, Belmont Bruins. Here's Clark. Only 7 points on the night and only 1 3-pointer from the leader in three-point percentage in the nation.
Blew the whistle. They didn't hear it.
Inadvertent whistle on Tim Gaddis's part, but he did get the foul called inside. And Ian Clark will go to the line. We have a media timeout with 11:46 to go.
Second shot, knocking it out. Murray State has been intense. They've been consistent. And that play was one of my favorites right there off of a setup. Belmont has come out. They've competed. But Murray State has raised their game and taken advantage of every miscue of Belmont.
Murray State's done all the little things as well. They average 14 turnovers a game. Tonight, only four. And they've assisted on 12 of their 19 field goals.
Well, they have the respect of Belmont. Belmont, the greatest compliments you can have for an opponent is to play hard. Murray State is playing hard. This is their home court. This is their conference. Belmont's undefeated. This is a good basketball game.
As Mouchette had a look out from behind, almost a steal. And Murray State got fortunate on that one.
I like Chamberlain. I like the intensity he brings off the bench. Comes out, plays hard. Doesn't have the world's greatest talent, but he plays hard.
Wilson, window, good. 14 points for Stacy Wilson, his first two of the second half. Back up to a 15-point edge.
This game could jumpstart the rest of the season for Stacy Wilson and his ability and the confidence that he's had.
Clark looking to get on track, showing a little bit of frustration on that miss. Here's Moss for three. And a rebound by Clark over Ed Daniel.
Well, that's a good play. Ed doing a little acting there. And good. Basket hanging. He's waiting.
Good hands by the Murray State defense. A near steal by Cannon. Wilson completes the task. Cannon, a foul. And it doesn't look like they're going to count the bucket. Offensive foul on Isaiah Cannon. That's his third, and Steve Prohme is irate.
Well, that's two of them picked up off of the defense of Chamberlain. Good job by Chamberlain again to pick up fouls off of Isaiah on the dribble.
10:35 to go. Your team's up 15. Do you sit Isaiah Cannon with three fouls?
Well, you know what? Coach trusts him right now. He's a senior, staying within his game, and the best defender right now on him is sitting down, so that shouldn't be a problem.
Here's Johnson trying to pick up foul number four on Cannon, and Cannon can basically only watch as Johnson picks up a layup.
Well, right now, that wouldn't hurt you. It would be more detrimental if he picked up that fourth foul. But again, I like what Chamberlain did. Picked up two fouls, which isn't easy to do on Isaiah off the dribble.
Here's Cannon. Amidst a sea of blue jerseys, and he's going to go to the line and shoot, too.
Well, he can sense the moment.
Well, we're seeing arguably the two best players in the OVC going head-to-head, and Isaiah Cannon, not only one of the best players in the conference, but one of the best in the country. Taking a look at tonight's Wendy's Wooden Watch, he certainly is one of the top 25 candidates, as he was a year ago as well, when he won OVC Player of the Year, was an All-American, and he has lived up to the hype. And he told us before the game, he's facing double teams on every possession, every game from every opponent, still averaging 21 points a game.
He won't see that at the next level because you got even better skilled players at every position. I've been impressed with how he's allowed the game to come to him, because you can see that he really wants to go off for 30 or 40, but he's played within the offense with his teammates.
And Cannon with the strip. Wilson, spot up three. Daniel. And the foul is going to go on Wilson. How about Isaiah Cannon? 6 for 7 from the free throw line, realizing that it's not so easy to get his shot up, but affecting the games in so many different ways.
Well, you look at he and Ed Daniel. Ed has not scored a lot of baskets or taken a lot of shot attempts, but they're moving the basketball. The defensive intensity has been there. And Belmont is not a team that you can sleep on because they shoot the ball so well, and they're one of the most efficient teams in the nation.
And that's senior leadership. That's one of the main reasons why this senior class, headlined by number 2 Ed Daniel and Isaiah Cannon, they have 101 career wins coming into tonight. And the previous senior class holds the record with 104.
Yeah, and we're going against a guy that's got 95. And Ian Clark, but he reminds me of Vince the Prince Hamilton from Clemson. You got to go back in my ear, 1985. Who? 1,500 points. Vince Hamilton, 10th all-time leading scorer. And what it is they were elusive. Vince had a jerry curl. This guy here is elusive, hard to guard.
Nice leave. And Ron Johnson with the assist to Blake Jennings. Jennings leading all scorers for the Belmont Bruins with 12 points.
Well, Belmont's giving you everything they got. They just haven't been able to match the intensity off the glass. The second shots, they've gotten better points in the paint in the second half, but the rebound, and right there, it's hurting.
Johnson too hard. Second chance for Belmont. Nice leave again. There's Ian Clark. And Clark is in double digits with 11.
Rich, as I sit here as a former player, I keep looking at Clark and I say, I've seen this guy before. I've seen it. And because he moves so well without the basketball, a slender build, but yet he's strong, good stamina. This young man is hard to guard. He's still getting his points in the flow, even though this has not been a lights-out performance by their team.
And Mushat, the Wiley senior, wisely calls a timeout. Latrez Mushat has been one of those keys to Murray State turning it on this latter part of the season. He was out on Watch ESPN. We talk about Ed Daniel with double-doubles. Mason Plumlee is a double-double machine in his own right.
Running rim run to rim run, playing huge form, staying out of foul trouble. But I really thought that Duke was a national contender for national championship with Ryan Kelly. Didn't have the same team without that guy.
Steve Prohm, his team up handily, 13 points, still working the officials. Talking to Steve Devine there on the sidelines. Coach's job is never done.
Well, of course not, because you're playing against a veteran team that can score quickly, and they have a good floor game. They just haven't matched the inside toughness, rebounding, and second shots that Murray State has.
Belmont's unblemished OVC mark is at stake here in serious jeopardy. We're going to get a foul on Belmont on the floor. And we touched on the keys to the game at the top in our one-on-one. Of course, you can't have a one-on-one with Murray State without talking about Isaiah Cannon. Same goes for Belmont and Ian Clark.
Exactly. Two good scores. They've played within the flow of the offense. You can see where Ian Clark is hard to guard because he's so elusive and quick, can move it off the basketball, catch it off the bounce. And then for Isaiah, that move he just made can put you to sleep and then cross over quickly and get inside the lane.
He now has a Baker's dozen, and all of his points in the second half have come from the free throw line. He's a 78% free throw shooter, increasing that percentage with tonight's performance. Only one miss from the line so far.
Murray State's in control of this game, but it's also because his teammates have really helped him out. Stacy Wilson has had a fine game, double figures. Fields, his favorite line, the three-point line, has worked for him in this game.
There's Clark trying to create. Three-pointer's good by Craig Bradshaw. No quitting these Bruins. There's a timeout on the floor, 7:50 right now, with 7:58 to go. And Belmont dangerously close to suffering their first loss in their brand new conference, the Ohio Valley.
Well, in the second half, Belmont has actually closed the gap. They've got more points in the paint, 26 now, and also fast break points. Though they haven't run a lot, they've got more fast break points, 6-4, and the bench, led by Chamberlain, has done a good job.
Now we see some full court pressure trying to force the issue on Belmont's part.
The poise by Murray State to break the press, to recognize and not be rattled, has really helped them in this second half.
Almost turns it over. Daniel with 9 on the shot clock. Cannon pulls it out with 6 on the shot clock. In and out on the 3. Clark has been harassed all night by Stacy Wilson.
He still keeps his poise. He still sees the defense. That was a tough shot. It's a makeable shot for him. But that was a good job by Murray State just to stay in front of him and let him shoot a contested 2- or 3-point shot.
I don't know if it's akin to seeing pigs fly, but Ian Clark is 1-for-4 from 3-point range tonight. You just do not see that very often from the top marksman from 3-point range in the country.
I wasn't ready for that one. Used to seeing pigs fly. That's pretty good. You must have some little kids at home.
Under 7 minutes to go. 12-point Murray State lead with the ball.
For Murray State, they're in control of this game, but they have to continue to attack. You don't want the Bruins to feel like they can come back on you.
Inside Daniel, low post. There's the double team, there's the kick out, and there's the 3. Five points for Latrez Mushak.
That was basketball by the number. Isaiah Cannon with the deep post to Ed Daniel, the pass out to the waiting three-point shooter.
And Mushak aggressive on defense, but they're going to whistle him for the foul.
Now you can see Karan Johnson, who scored over 1,000 points. Taking his time, he knows his team needs a basket, a good percentage shot, goes to the basket and draws the foul.
Johnson has 7 points. He's third in the conference in assists, but they need his scoring right now.
Well, they're smart players here. Rich, you can't cut corners on either team with seniors. They recognize both teams are very intelligent, have great feels for the game. And again, for Belmont, though they have not been able to lead except for one time, still a sharp.
Surprised here that Ian Clark's sitting on the bench. What's the strategy with Rick Burke?
Well, you want to come down with a strong finish. You got to get some stops defensively. Chamberlain has done a wonderful job defensively. You got to scrap it up.
Burke must have sensed that Clark needed a little bit of a breather going into crunch time.
They'll need his offense coming down the stretch, but they need some stops more importantly right now.
Off the foot of Bradshaw, it'll stay Murray State basketball. Murray State's going small, 4 guards and Ed Daniel on the floor.
Yeah, we have not seen Brandon Garrett, who's had a big game as well, 13 points and 2 blocks.
Murray State, a 4-point underdog on their home court to the Belmont Bruins. They're 6 minutes away from wiping that clean. Cannon rises up, knocks it down.
The value of an All-American is he can make a shot when chaos breaks loose on the offensive end.
16 points now for Isaiah Cannon, about 5 off his season average.
Isaiah got picked off. He's upset with his teammates that you got to call a pick. Usually that's Ed Daniel or Mushak. Got to let them know you're a traffic cop in the back. You can see what a point guard can't because his back is to the defense.
Johnson back to the line. Daniel, his third foul. Both teams in the bonus. Johnson misses that one. His second miss from the free throw line tonight. And Adam Barnes, number 24, first time he's checking into the game for Rick Bird. Bradshaw to the bench.
Need more quickness, more speed, and a lot of times Murray State has won the battle of the broken plays.
One for two for Johnson. He's in double digits, the fourth Bruin in double digits. So balanced scoring for Belmont, but they just have not been able to do what they normally do, which is knock down the ball from beyond the arc.
And that helps because of Murray State, the scouting report again, trying to get them to shoot challenge three-point shots.
Cannon handles the pressure. Fields in the corner. Great follow by Mushat, but just didn't have the lift. Johnson in the lane.
Getting to his left hand, looking like a little tiny Archibald right now. The quickness. He's able to get inside the paint and get the shots that he wants. He's been carrying them on the offensive end for the last four possessions.
12 points for Johnson, a 12-point lead for Murray State. Coming up on 5 minutes to go.
Now it's all about the execution. Under 5 minutes for both teams. It's about execution.
Cannon might have gotten away with a little push. Instead, the foul called on Belmont. And with Murray State in the bonus, it'll be a one-and-one situation for Isaiah Cannon.
One thing about a senior-laden team, you don't have to coach the fundamentals with them. You're just talking about the execution. Let's get a pick and roll. Let's get it inside the paint. There's no guesswork. He knows exactly what he's going to get from a veteran team, and they're able to execute it. Again, we're talking about winners in the conferences that they've been in.
17 points for Cannon. Eighth leading scorer in the nation. He has 2 3-pointers tonight, and the rest of his points have come from where he is set up shop right now, from the free throw line. That's a game-high 18 points for Isaiah Cannon, the Wooden Award finalist. Clark back into the game and immediately hits the floater. He has 13.
The two scores, primary scores, Clark and Johnson, have cracked the code with Murray State with their penetration and five-footers inside now. Isaiah's just a little quicker than the point guards for Belmont, and he's been able to get what he wants. He's got a strong handle, and they have not been able to keep him out the paint.
Fields loves that shot, not this time. Dangerous pass, but it leads to an easy layup. And that's the first 2 points of the night for Trevor Nowak, who averages 12 and a half coming in. Call a jump ball, and it's going to be possession Belmont. That was right in front of us, AB, and it looked like Stacy Wilson was trying to call a timeout.
That was pretty quick, but this is a trap area right here. You can't pick up your dribble right here. Belmont's making a run. Rick Bird has emptied his bench trying to find a combination that can get stops, because now offensively their two primary guards that have scored over 2,000 points collectively have been getting their shots at the rim.
Well, they trail it by 10. A three-pointer here, which is not a stretch for Belmont,
yep,
would close the gap to 7. They haven't been closer than 8 points in this half.
And let's see if the next shot gets inside for either layup or three-pointer. Good patience by the Bruins.
The three-pointer is good. Brandon Baker, his first three of the game, and it's a 7-point lead.
See it coming like clockwork. The Johnson able to keep it going around the 8-minute mark.
Aggressive D by Ian Clark. He picks up the foul. We've got a ball game with 3:22 to go. Belmont has scratched away and has cut into Murray State.
Double figures, and this is a three-possession game now.
Shooting at 48.9% for the game, but 62% in this half. They're on a 10-2 run. And Wilson hits the front end of the 1-1.
Well, Murray State's got to continue to make baskets, and they've got to tighten up on the defensive end because Caron Johnson has been beating them off the dribble inside the paint, and so has Ian Clark.
Wilson has 15. Make it 16. Back up to a three-possession ball game with 3:20 to go. And Tim Gattis
looking at the shot clock.
Stops the clock.
Steve Prohm has decided to go with small ball. And Brandon Garrett, who they haven't had an answer for, has been sitting down. So Coach feels like Mushak can make this run with him and guard the three-point line.
Not quite sure why he's made that decision. Garrett only has one foul. But Steve Prohm content to go small.
Hold on to your seatbelts. We got our game. 3:15 left.
Noah with the seam. Can't hit the layup. Just the presence of number two, Ed Daniel, was enough.
Well, that was a strong drive by Noack. Just didn't finish, but an excellent decision to go in there strong.
Belmont has won 51 of their last 54 conference games. And with 2:43 to go, let's take a look at the OVC standings right now. Murray State looking for their eighth win in conference, whereas Belmont is 10-0. They are on the verge of suffering their first loss in conference.
And left only one lead, I think, the entire game. Murray State has led from start to finish practically the entire game.
And they got the foul on Brandon Baker.
That was a good old-fashioned hack. Got his money's worth on that one.
And Daniel will go to the line and shoot. Daniel's been quiet offensively, only 4 points up to this point, but he has affected the game in a number of ways. Block shots, steals, even assists. And now in the double bonus, Murray State gets two shots. Daniel misses the first.
Ed gives up on that free throw too easy. He's got a great form. Reminds me of Dennis Rodman, believe it or not, at the free throw line. Dennis had a great form and a great follow through, but it's like he really didn't care. He's ready to rebound. Good follow through.
Daniel goes one for two, and it's back up to a double-digit lead with 2:35 to go. Noah, three. Good. Trevor Noah, his first three of the game.
Closest they've been as well. 7-point game now. That was an excellent execution in sharing the basketball.
And if Trevor Noack suddenly gets hot, look out. He had 30 points in a game against Southeast Missouri earlier this year. 15 games in double figures.
Well, wide open of shooter. Again, let's say again how these teams have won championships. So they know how to execute. They know how to pay attention to detail. And for a three-point shooting team, which both teams are, 231's an eternity.
Dangerous pass, taken away. Belmont, a chance, Clark, yes! 16 for Ian Clark. And it's a 4-point Murray State lead.
That was a poor decision.
The possession arrow, so every subsequent Belmont foul, Murray State will be shooting a guaranteed 2 free throws.
Well, Belmont right now has the momentum. They're believing quietly that the pressure is on Murray State to execute. First, you got to get the ball in bounds and then get it to your right ball handlers.
Cannon with the ball. Takes it himself, but he's fouled by Noah. Isaiah Cannon will go back to the line.
This is just what Murray State worked on in the shoot-around. Breaking the press, throwing it ahead. Isaiah making a good decision. He had Ed Daniels in his sights the entire time, but was able to finish strong. And for pro scouts, you can see him taking body contact and still getting the shot up at the rim.
Cannon near perfect from the line tonight. He has 19 points.
I've been impressed with Coach Bird, the legend, who's got, what, nearly over 500 wins, the way he's been plugging in his guys. He tried to go zone for a while, tried to go small ball, emptied out his bench just to see if he can make stops and get himself a chance to win, and he's done that.
Now 20 points for Isaiah Cannon, his team up six.
Look at the confidence Belmont's moving with now.
Nowak to the hole. 4-point game, and Steve Prohm and company want to talk it over. With 2:06 to go, Murray State, a tentative 72-68 lead over Belmont. Let's send it back to the ESPNU studios.
The sixth man from making noise.
The Bruins riding a 10-game win streak into this contest. That's fifth in the nation.
Latrez Mouchat has to be confident. He's got some open passes. He's got to be confident getting that ball in bounds. He's looked shaky the last three times he's taken it out. He's got an open shooter right there. Doesn't look confident passing that basketball.
And they finally get the ball in the hands of Isaiah Cannon. Ball's out of bounds. And the officials looking to each other to figure out whose ball it is.
Good job by Belmont letting the ball find Latrez, because he's been looking shaky right now with the hand on, making his decisions, trying to keep it out of Isaiah Cannon's hand.
Murray State ball under their own basket, 1:56 to go. This is as close as Belmont has been since early in the first half. An undefeated conference record at stake for the Bruins.
That crossover is pretty slippery.
Chamberlain's not biting. Five to shoot. Wilson in the lane, the floater. No good. Rebound, Noah.
Belmont wins that possession because Isaiah didn't shoot it as well. This is the time where you want your best offensive shooter with the ball in his hands.
And the ball goes off the hands of number two, Blake Jenkins.
When you're taking the ball out, you see a white jersey clear, put it the responsibility on the receiver, throw him a good pass, and let him go get it. There you go.
And they'll get Jenkins on the foul, and Isaiah Cannon back in familiar territory at the free throw line.
Well, you don't want a degree of difficulty. You want to keep it simple. Isaiah Cannon's your best ball handler, your best player. You want to put it in his hands. You want the game to be won or lost with their best players. Look at this second now. Under the last 3 minutes, everything Belmont is doing, they've gotten the shots that they want. They've been able to scramble the defense of Murray State, because now they have five scores at every position, and if you break down off the dribble drive, they leave open, they leave it open for shooters.
Isaiah Cannon is 13 for 14 from the charity stripe. That is a career high in terms of free throws made for the senior All-American. And they've all come in the second half. Not normally the way Isaiah Cannon could beat you, but he's beating Belmont nonetheless. 6-point lead for Murray State, 1:20 to go. Clark, three, yes! Cold-blooded three from number 21 in blue.
Comfortable. He's gotten comfortable shooting a 3-point shot. He's gotten it.
Time anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at WatchESPN.com and with the Watch ESPN app. We have a one-possession ball game with 1:16 to go.
It's about the execution now, getting the ball in bounds. Good job. Valley Trez, better job.
Look out. Murray State turnover. Nowak has it for Belmont.
It's not his fault. Isaiah Cannon's got to go get the basketball. He and Wilson. It's not his fault.
A chance to tie with a three. Clark. Yes! Can you believe it? 22 for Clark. We're knotted at 74 under a minute to go.
All the pressure and the responsibility now is on Murray State to execute. Look for Isaiah typically on a high screen and roll.
Cannon tries to answer. He does! Isaiah Cannon now has a game-high 25. Clark, a team-high 22. We have 33.9 seconds to go. The shot clock is off, and it's a one-possession ball game.
Well, you got to guard the three-point line. You prefer him shooting a two-point shot.
Clark lost the handle.
Isaiah having a conversation here in Clark. It's competitive. They're going at it.
Steve Prohm telling us before the game, Isaiah Cannon has been dialed in leading up to this one more than he's ever seen him. He says, this is my team, this is my league, and this is the first chance he's had to show Belmont what he's got.
Well, documentation beats conversation, so if you can sit there and pull it out and perform it out, you can say something. Got to get it over half court.
Isaiah Cannon will go to the line again.
Rick Murray going offense for defense now. Bringing Clark back in. Bringing Johnson back in.
Well, we're not done here just yet, but coming up next, stick around. Pac-12 basketball, Colorado versus number 19, Oregon. Ironically, it was the Colorado Buffaloes who defeated Murray State in the Charleston Classic Finals back in November.
He's got to hit this shot here, making it a two-possession game now. So this is a huge basket for him, making it 4 points, because we've seen Belmont make quick work at a three-point line.
Cannon, a rare miss from the free throw line. He's 14 for 16 on the evening.
And for Murray State, you got to identify the shooters. Get to the shooters quickly. Get to those blue jerseys quickly.
Cannon has 26, and it's a two-possession ball game. No timeout for Belmont. They're going to have to hustle. Man, a deep three. In and out. Daniel, the rebound. .6 left here. Ed Daniel will shoot two to try to ice it for Murray State. If you're tuning in to see Colorado and Oregon, you can check them out on ESPN News. That game will switch over to ESPNU immediately following the conclusion of this one.
Murray State has done an excellent job of answering the call by Belmont. Belmont came on, was on fire coming down the home stretch at the three-point line.
Daniel stepped over the free throw line. That's a violation.
Don't be surprised to see them again in the finals or semifinals. Two excellent teams.
That's right. If they both win out in their conferences and end up the one seeds, they will both have double buys into the semifinals of the OVC tournament. Here's a steal and the icing on the cake. The Murray State Racers, home underdogs to the Belmont Bruins, come away with a gutsy 5-point win. Your final score, Murray State 79, Belmont 74. Coming up next, College.